On October 14, 2024, NASA successfully launched the Europa Clipper mission, marking the beginning of a landmark journey to one of the most intriguing moons in our solar system, Jupiter's icy moon, Europa. Scientists have long been fascinated by Europa, as evidence suggests that beneath its thick shell of ice lies a vast, hidden ocean. The possibility that this ocean could contain the conditions necessary for life makes Europa one of the top targets in the search for life. This mission is not just another space exploration project. It's a major step toward answering the age-old question: are we alone in the universe? Over the next 5.5 years, the spacecraft will make its way across the vast expanse of our solar system, eventually reaching Jupiter, where it will perform an intricate series of flybys to analyze Europa's ocean and geological activity in unprecedented detail. Europa is not just any moon. It's one of the four largest of Jupiter's moons, known as the Galilean moons, which were first observed by Galileo Galilei in 1610. Since its discovery, Europa has intrigued scientists because of its smooth and bright surface, unlike the cratered, rocky surfaces of most moons. But the real fascination came in recent decades when missions like Voyager and Galileo provided compelling evidence that beneath Europa's icy exterior might be a global ocean, possibly twice as large as all of Earth's oceans combined. Water is a key ingredient for life as we know it, and wherever we find water on Earth, life thrives. Europa Clipper's mission is to investigate whether this moon has the right conditions to support microbial life, even though it won't search for life directly. Instead, it will study the chemistry, temperature, and potential interactions between the ice, ocean, and Europa's rocky core, all factors that could influence habitability. The spacecraft launched aboard a powerful SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket from Cape Canaveral, Florida, marking an important milestone in NASA's exploration of the outer solar system. After the successful launch, Europa Clipper began its long trek toward Mars, where it will make its first gravity assist in February 2025. A gravity assist is a clever technique used by spacecraft to gain speed and change trajectory by flying close to a planet and utilizing its gravitational pull. The flyby of Mars will give the spacecraft the necessary momentum to continue its journey through space. In December 2026, Europa Clipper will return to Earth's vicinity for a final gravity assist, using our planet's gravity to accelerate and propel itself toward its ultimate destination, Jupiter. If all goes according to plan, Europa Clipper will arrive at Jupiter on April 11, 2030, after more than 5 years of interplanetary travel. After arrival, Europa Clipper will not orbit Europa directly, as Jupiter's radiation belts create an extremely hostile environment for spacecraft. Instead, the spacecraft will enter into an elliptical orbit around Jupiter, where it can dip close to Europa for detailed observations and then retreat to safer distances. Rather than orbiting Europa continuously, Europa Clipper will perform 49 flybys of the icy moon during its mission. This design allows the spacecraft to avoid prolonged exposure to the intense radiation from Jupiter's powerful magnetosphere, which could damage its sensitive electronics. The magnetosphere of Jupiter is one of the most dangerous environments in the solar system for a spacecraft, with radiation levels that could easily destroy unshielded electronics in a short time. By keeping its distance and only approaching Europa for short intervals, Europa Clipper can safely gather data during its flybys without risking long-term damage. During some of these close encounters, The spacecraft will fly as low as 16 miles or 25 kilometers above Europa's surface, giving it a chance to capture stunning high-resolution images and collect valuable data about the moon's ice shell, surface features, and potential water plumes. Radiation is a major concern for missions exploring the outer planets, especially in regions close to gas giants like Jupiter, which have strong magnetic fields trapping high-energy particles. For Europa Clipper, engineers designed a radiation-hardened vault that houses the spacecraft's most sensitive electronics, similar to the protective system used on NASA's Juno mission. This vault will allow Europa Clipper to withstand the extreme radiation environment. But even with this protection, the spacecraft must minimize its exposure by keeping a safe distance from Jupiter during most of its orbit. By using a flyby approach, Europa Clipper can achieve the mission's science goals while extending the spacecraft's operational life in this harsh environment. Europa has captivated scientists since the days of the Voyager missions, which provided the first close-up images of its enigmatic surface. Scientists estimate that Europa's ocean could be between 31 and 93 miles, or 50 to 150 kilometers deep, hidden beneath an ice shell that is itself around 3 to 25 miles, or 5 to 40 kilometers thick. This vast, hidden ocean could contain more water than all of Earth's oceans combined. But the real question is whether this ocean interacts with Europa's rocky seafloor, which could create environments similar to Earth's deep-sea hydrothermal vents, places where life thrives despite the absence of sunlight. On Earth, life exists in extreme environments, such as the hydrothermal vents found at the bottom of the ocean, where heat and minerals from the Earth's mantle provide the energy needed for life to thrive, even in the absence of sunlight. If similar conditions exist on Europa, microbial life could potentially survive in its ocean. Understanding whether Europa's ocean has the necessary ingredients for life is one of the key scientific goals of the Europa Clipper mission. To investigate this, Europa Clipper will carry a suite of scientific instruments that will study the moon's ice shell, ocean, and surface in unprecedented detail. The scientific payload aboard the Europa Clipper is among the most advanced ever sent to study a moon. Its Europa Imaging System, EIS, will capture high-resolution images of Europa's surface, mapping about 90% of it with a resolution as fine as 1.5 feet or 0.5 meters per pixel during close flybys. With the help of EIS, scientists can closely examine Europa's surface, which is marked by a network of cracks, ridges, and chaotic terrain. These features suggest that the ice shell is constantly shifting, likely due to tidal forces from Jupiter's gravity. By mapping these surface features in detail, scientists aim to gain insights into the behavior of the ice shell and its interaction with the subsurface ocean. In addition, the eThemis thermal imaging system will search for warmer regions on the surface that might indicate liquid water lying close beneath the ice, potentially revealing locations where the ice shell is thin or where the ocean is actively interacting with the surface. eThemis will play a crucial role in identifying potential hot spots on the surface where the ocean might be closer to the surface, which could be prime locations for future exploration. As we conclude this exploration of the Europa Clipper mission, we stand on the cusp of discovery, eager to unravel the mysteries of one of the most captivating moons in our solar system. This mission not only represents a significant leap in our understanding of Europa, but also symbolizes humanity's enduring quest to explore the unknown. With each flyby and each piece of data collected, we draw closer to answering profound questions about the potential for life beyond our planet. The journey is just beginning, and the insights we gain from Europa Clipper will inspire generations to come, reminding us that our search for knowledge is a shared adventure that knows no bounds. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our channel. We have exciting plans for more interesting content about space and beyond. Thank you for watching.